Hey everybody, it's Evicta. It's time to continue our eating streak here in the Mining of Isaac Evicta Afterbirth Plus series. We did it, y'all did it. We got to 60 days in a row in record time today, actually, for Seed League Heroes, a brand new series, well, mini series, possibly turning it into a full-fledged series beginning next week. So start submitting those seeds. And we're going to keep on going with the like streak here. Now I've got the next one for you, the next like streak. Incentive this time around is if we hit 90 days, 90 as in 90, then I will give away 2 copies of The Binding of Isaac, including Afterbirth Plus. So, and I'll give that away. That'll be exclusive to YouTube. But that will require me to add you to Steam because it's just easier for me to do it that way. So that's what I'm going to decide to do for the 90-day like streak. If we actually do hit 90 days, I will give away 2 copies of Isaac, including Afterbirth Plus DLC, to those of you fine folk here on YouTube for making the like streak such an amazing part of my channel's history and beyond. Hopefully that's worth it to y'all. 236 in a row, 403 Eden tokens because we're sitting at 403 now. Yeah, okay. Seed day is going to be 7, Echo, 8, 6, Quebec, Victor, Bravo, 3. We've got Judas's freaking, say it with me, everyone, Shadow, along with Acid Baby and the Jar. Now, remember, we did get Eden's Blessing towards the, I want to say, like, the middle of yesterday's rerolling Bonanza. So that's where the extra item came from. The extra item in this case is going to be Judas's Shadow, and what an extra item to get. Now, obviously, with Curse of the XL, or Curse of the Unknown, we have no idea what our HP is going to be. I'm very happy that we have Jar of Flies, because Jar of Flies is very good, especially when we have a high base tier damage, but obviously we don't have that until after we turn into Black Judas, which I will be doing. It appears that we did have a Soul Heart, so we just lost it there. We've got decent movement speed. It's definitely below average damage, but I mean anything over 3 is acceptable, I suppose. And by the way, yes, shout out for us getting straight to, for going straight on into Izarize, going straight on into the dead end here to start off. Start submitting in those seeds for Seed League Heroes, and I'm not gonna do like any like I don't want to do voting. Oh my goodness, we can get the Cantor Trinket. I'm not going to do like how we did similarly in Darkest Dungeon where people just sort of vote on what their picks are because I think that's going to take too long and honestly it's going to require too much effort from people. What I'm going to do for Seed League Heroes for now anyway, just to start out just for now, what I plan on doing is I'm going to just check out the seeds and read the descriptions. Hopefully people do not spoil them and like just flat out tell me like, oh yeah, this is what you end up getting with you. I'll make a short video. It's going to be a very brief video outlining exactly what I want from people. If you are wanting to submit your own seed for Seed League Heroes, I'm going to need the hashtag Seed League Heroes that you see down below in the bottom portion of your screen. You're going to need that because that's what I'm going to use to track the people wanting to submit their seeds for that. Secondly, I'm going to need the character. Thirdly, I'm going to need the starting items. And if it's not Eden, then I need to know exactly what was in the first item room. That way, I can use that info to verify whether or not I have the correct seed, and then we'll just go from there. So, and I know that there's still going to be some discrepancies, I'm sure, whenever it comes to me going through Seed League Heroes, and that's probably due to the fact that like I just flat out just don't know what kind of seeds I'm going to be playing. But again, that's where you all come in. So the more information you give me without spoiling it, the better chance you have for me to pick it. And of course, I'm not going to guarantee that people's seeds are going to be picked because obviously there's going to be a lot of people. I have a feeling a lot of people are going to be submitting their seeds here. So we see this this triple Blackheart super secret room, and that's enough to convince me that we need to turn into Black Judas here on floor 1 instead of waiting until the Devil Deal on floor 2. Which means now what I'm going to be looking for is like an arcade, which is not going to happen on floor 1. A self-sacrifice room. I mean, HP doesn't really matter right now. But having 3 soul hearts there, multi-dimensional baby is kind of eh. I have a feeling, I bet you that the secret room is probably to the south of the item room. to the east of the cursed room here. Fortunately, we don't have any bombs, and we are still not going to have any bombs. Wow, balls of steel here. Question. Speed up. There we go. So we get a balls of steel pill along with a speed up, and I'm honestly fine with that. Are we down to red hearts yet? We are not. All right, so I have a feeling that we're probably down to red hearts soon. Health up. What is going on? Like, seriously, what is going on now, game? I'm a little bit confused. I mean, I'm glad that you gave us Judas's Shadow. I'm not going to poo-poo that. But, like, I'm just trying to turn into Black Judas, and you keep giving me all this bounty of HP goodness, which is a lot different than HP Lovecraft. Although some would probably argue that it's still HP goodness. We're still going to turn into Black Judas here. Yeah, especially with that. Okay. Okay, so let's turn into Black Judas. We have no idea how much HP we started with. It seems like quite a lot. Respawn as Black Judas here. Now we get to take that. I'm not going to use the ball as a steel pill. You might be going, Yes, Tim Allen. I'm not using the ball as a steel pill yet because... What if we get placebo in the next shop? It won't be this shop because we don't have a key. But maybe the next shop. So yeah, so that's the three things I need from you. I need hashtag Seed League Heroes. I need to know exactly what Isaac character, if it was Eden, Judas, Samson, Apollyon, you know. Oh my god, what is... Look, game, you don't owe me anything. We get Black freaking Candle. For free in the freaking cursed room on the second freaking floor for free. Did I mention it was free? Yeah, so I need the hashtag Seed League Heroes, the seed, obviously, the character that you played as, and then what is the, either if it's an Eden run, what is the starting items that I'm supposed to be seeing, and if it's not an Eden run, then like, say, what is in the first item room that I see. Because that's what I'm going to use to verify whether or not we are working with the exact same seeds. Oh, Monstro. Nothing. Jar of Flies, by the way, is our spacebar item, and it will... Yes, I will take a speed up. Thank you very much. It will spawn an attack fly every time that we kill an enemy. But it won't spawn it on Isaac. We actually control when it spawns. We release them out of the jar, and it's a very, very good, very awesome spacer item that you should use more often if you're not already. Now, something that you may have already noticed here, and it might have been a question that you were just getting ready to ask, is what if a fly kills an enemy, does that spawn another fly? No, it's not a perpetual fly spawner. The only flies that are generated are the ones that Isaac, that are coming from the enemies that Isaac kills with his tears only, not with the other flies. That was just terrible. Got another speed up pill? Wow. Okay, so let's go fight the boss real quick. It's gonna be Monstro. He's already dead. I mean, we're Black Judas on floor two. Like, this is just gonna be a runaway slam dunk. Mom's coin purse. Now, yes, if you are asking, well, how come you're taking all these pills, Sinvicta? Okay, well, I mean, I really cannot complain about what we've gotten, given the fact that we've gotten amazing items on this run, so I'm not gonna. But the reason why I was taking pills at the start there anyway was just because I wanted to see if we can get a tears up. It would have been nice. But because we were just getting a string of positive pills over and over again. Yes, I know there's a Tenet Rock there. I just wanted to see. Oh my goodness, we even get PH Dizzle. PH Dizzle with telepills. Let's get this Tenet Rock. We already have Small Rock, so I mean, you know, what else can we get? Bloody Penny? Nah, I don't think so. I am disinclined to acquiesce your requests. Telepills. I'll save the telepills for the next... No, let's do it now. Because if we get taken to the Imera room, I'm going to be really mad. Yeah. All right, well, we have another telepills here. Might as well just try to go for broke here. Why not? Yeah, yeah. All right, all right. Hello. Hello, sir. Ooh, Baby Bender's not... Does Baby Bender work with Multi-dimensional baby? I don't think so. Something's wrong. No, thank you. No, I am error room. Well, I tried. We'll stick with the cancer trinket. Head on down to the next floor. But I mean, this is a A plus quality start right here. Being Black Judas already. Yeah, I'll take out the telepills. So, and one thing I will say, this is something that I had to say in the Darkest Dungeon series, just because it's inevitable. If I don't take your seed for Seed League Heroes, and you see someone else's who you perceive to be like, you know, why'd you take so-and-so's? Their seed sucked. My seed was way better, that sort of thing. Don't take it personally. If I don't take your seed, or if I try it out, and then you submit one, then like it, then you just don't see it on the series for whatever reason. Don't take it personally. All right. There's going to be no bias towards any one person as far as Seed League Heroes are concerned. The only thing I'm interested in is simply playing the worst of the worst, just to see if we can do them. Now, I'm not going to guarantee that we're going to beat all of them. A lot of people were submitting the one that, like, say, Cobalt Streak lost his Eden Streak on, which I was actually, back in the day when I actually watched Twitch for, you know, relaxation, I saw him play that run, and I'm pretty sure that I'm not going to be able to beat it, but I'm going to try. I should probably add another stipulation to that. I don't care about the telepills. Another thing that I'm going to need is I need to know, well, what's the best way I can do this? Because I don't want to have to switch back and forth between versions of Isaac. So, like, if it's a rebirth, if it's like a rebirth or an anti-birth seed, I'm going to disqualify that. And I only say that because it's just out of necessity. The purpose of this mini-series is not to create even more work. For me. Not that I'm trying to be lazy, of course, or anything like that. And we have tears up. It's good. But hopefully you understand, because, like, I don't want to have to switch back and forth, like, oh, this is a rebirth seed, or oh, this is an anti-birth seed, or oh, this is an anti-birth plus seed. So make sure the seeds that you submit are anti-birth plus. By anti-birth, I mean afterbirth. God. I'm going to be confusing the hell out of everybody. Okay, so four rules total, alright? Four total rules for dating my teenage stepdaughter. Also, for submitting your seeds for Seed League Heroes. Has to be Afterbirth Plus. You have to give me the seed. You have to give me the character, and you have to give me the starting items if it's an Eden run, or give me the starting item room items so I can verify whether or not that we're working on a similar seed. There's no guarantee that we're gonna have the same seed for the entire run, of course. But as long as our starts are relatively the same, then that's satisfactory for me. Once I put together that video, it's going to be a lot less confusing. I mean, it's really not all that confusing. At least I hope it's not, anyway. No deal with the devil. No surprise there. Head on down to the next floor. Growth hormones, of course, are going to be great. Our movement speed is a little bit too high now, but our damage is starting to really take shape. And remember, every time that we get a damage up, our flies are going to do even more damage than that. People... You guys and you gals are making me laugh in the comments the other day when I mentioned the bear that had the heart attack and, like, you know, rolled down the hill. And I said, I didn't even realize I did it. And that's 100% truth on that. I had no idea that I did it, but apparently I said it makes you have, like, a pause or something like that. Or it makes you pause to think. It was something like that. Oh, it goes out. I'm drowsy. And people were like, you know, was the bear pun deliberate? I'm like, come on. It doesn't have to be a bear pun because someone says pause. Like, come on now. Like, there's many other animals in the animal kingdom that have paws. But I was laughing nonetheless because it was pretty funny. But somebody in Twitch chat tonight was asking if I would link them the video. And I was like, eh, I mean, you can find it. It's not that hard of a video to find. Oh no. I just thought it was funny because the attitude of the guy who was narrating it was completely just it wasn't matching the, oh my god, I don't know how he didn't get hit by that leaper there. I saw it was next to Acid Baby. For whatever reason, I thought that was on my team. But hey, we didn't get it. It was just the absurdity of the of the commentary that made me really chuckle. Health up, I mean, sure. Alright, still looking for that item room. I have a feeling this is where the boss is. Yep. Normally, when you can find the super secret room, you're able to find the boss. Which is not what we're looking for. Right now, we're only looking for the item room. We don't even need the store, to be honest. Like, what are we going to buy in the store that's going to help out? We already have Black Candle. I mean, the compass, I guess. I'm not going to take either one. I know that I'm on record for saying that number two is actually really good, and I think it still is really good. Steam sale would be nice. If we can get half price compass, though, that'd be even nicer. Oh, there's like a 0% chance that we actually see that, because that's like a 1 in a million chance that we're going to find the item that I'm looking for and at the price that we're looking for without Steam sale, of course. Champion belt. Now you're speaking my language here, game. Can we find 8 more cents? Please don't make any more sound. Thank you. Thank you very much. All right, mystery sack coming through. We only need 5 more. Just 1 nickel, and that gets us that sweet, sweet champion belt damage. Now, I could also go to the self-sacrifice room. Yeah, we are definitely going to gulp down the cancer trinket. We could go in the self-sack room, but we need to be real careful. Let's... Nickel? 4 cents. Not found this. We haven't found the regular secret room yet. We have found it. And there's our nickel. Alright. I guess we could go look inside the boss trap room now. If I didn't have a golden bomb, I would have never guessed right there. Yeah, let's do it. I mean, like, really, like, what's going to stop us? We have 12.91 damage. This is before champion belt, by the way. Oh, and I found out, thanks Pete for reminding me. I found out tonight, this is something that I did not know. Found out that euthanasia actually can destroy Peep and Bloat's eyes. I found that out on stream tonight. And when it happened, my mind was blown. I was like, what? That's exactly what I sounded like. I was like, what? I don't care about that. I'm drowsy pill. I don't really care about any of this, to be honest. This is a one run. We're Black Judas. What do we need? We need nothing. More damage? I'll take it. I was like, holy crap, you can destroy, euthanasia destroys the floater peep eyes. We did get a deal with the devil, which I have a feeling is going to be Krampus. It's not, it's actually Maw of the Void and the Book of Belial. Oh my, Gertie Gumdrops. We say thank you to the Jar of Flies. You might be wondering, why am I even going with the Book of Belial? It just makes everything stronger. I mean, that's really what it comes down to. It is nice having Jar of Flies. You could really convince me of either or there. But as far as general boss killing goes, the Book of Belial is just going to smoke anything that we come across. Maw of the Void, of course. I mean, yeah, this is a one run. And yeah, we're going to go... We'll try to fight everybody.
This is an amateur YouTuber syndicate tries to fight everybody.
I'll fight everybody. I don't care. Freaking bring it. Box of spiders. It's just a box of spiders. Now, we don't have unlimited bombs here, Brain, just so you know. Monster Manuel. I meant to touch Bob's brain there, or Bob's rotten head, so I can get out of the light item pool, but... Alright. People have been asking me to take Eden's Blessing a lot more lately, and I'm not sure why. Oh man, Hive Mind would have been great for Jar of Flies. We can use this Temperance Machine. I'm gonna try my best to get the boss rush here. We gotta book it though. Yeah, so I'm just going to deposit as much as I can here. Okay. And we'll get a moon card. So now I don't have to do boss rush, which I'm fine with. Fuck up, sure. Now I'm a little bit sad faced that we didn't go and buy the chaos card too. Not buy, but I'm a little bit sad that we didn't bomb the angel statue, because I could have gotten. We still have a chance, of course, if we find another self sacrifice room, but we can go fight Mega Satan, which would be nice. Go pay old Mega Stan a little visit. Secret room is not there. Okay. We have not been to the secret room yet, but that's why I was asking. But we have enough HP to go in here and just romp around, see what's up here. All right. We got health, another health up pill. Speed up. You don't know me like that. Speed up. Oh my goodness, even a Hierophant card. This is just a blessed start, man. Health up. We'll take the chaos card. We'll save that for Hush. Super Secret Room is almost always to the right of here. Tears up, you don't know me like that. Tears up, I'm gonna bring this one back. Eat, skirt. So we have a 3-tier delay now as Black Judas. That is scary talk right there. Book of Bilal boosts our damage to 20, and look, he's dead. We actually did get a double deal, and it's gonna be Krampus, who is also dead. Head of Krampus, don't really want. No thanks. And we'll just head on down to the next floor. We got just over a minute and a half to get to boss rush if we can make it. And since we've already been to the shop and done our due diligence and our depositing, I'm okay with skipping an item room here. What is hitting me? The first one looked like, oh, okay, so we did it. The first one looked like it was like maybe a shot, but the second one, I didn't see at all what that was. All right, it's gonna be another one of these good old-fashioned dead ends. All right. So we've gone two directions now, and both of them are incorrect. Maybe we can get lucky and find the third dead end. Greed fight, whatever. We got less than a minute, Judas. We gotta book it here, son. We gotta book it. Found it. We're actually gonna make it. I'm not using the Book of Bilal because I'm gonna save it for boss rush. Even though we could have boss rush anyway. Yeah, we'll go fight. We'll go fight the lamb. Why not? Oh! You talk about yourself like the perfect Black Judas run. Holy smithereens. We've got ourselves Libra. Libra Black Judas. Eden's Blessing with an uncapped tears rate. Good gravy. Miss Daisy. That is a lot of power. So what Libra does is Libra will attempt to balance all of our stats across all of them, all each other. And basically any stat up that we get is going to essentially be an all stats up. And why that's so significant for Black Judas is because of the damage multiplier that Black Judas gets. So with Black Judas and Libra, it's even more significant with every damage up, or especially damage up that we get, because it's going to raise our stats even by more than the default amount. Which means that we are in an impeccably perfect situation here to really ball out of control with Libra. I just felt like hitting Book of Wild again. It doesn't actually do anything. That'd be OP as all get out if it actually stacked. Oh my goodness, what a way to kick off Thursday. This is like the celebratory. We hit 60 like streaks in a row. The like streak hit 60, I should say, in a row. Of course, Maw of the Void gives us an air of protection here with our HP because we're going to be spawning black hearts on almost everything that we kill with it. Yeah, good luck, adversary. No shot's going to be hitting you in the back. From your back, I don't know what I'm talking about. I mean, if the items were terrible, I wasn't going to do boss rush. But, like, yeah. Get another gulp card. Unfortunately, we've already used gulp on the cancer trinket, so we don't have the trinket to gulp right now anyway. And yes, I could teleport out of here, but where's the fun in that? Speed up doesn't really do anything if they're capped. The only stat that we can get right now that would up all of our stats thanks to Libra's damage or luck. We could get damage, luck, or range, but I mean our range. Look, like we have a 51 range. Oh, and we even get Shoop the Whoop. Oh, Shoop, I love you. Now, yes, I could use the telepills to get back out and to go find that item room, but if we're gonna do a full house run. Not full houses in, like, the beloved 90s sitcom of, well, the 90s. But full houses, and we're gonna beat all bosses here. Then, you know, one item's not going to make that much of a difference. Plus, Shoop the Whoop's going to increase our killing power even more. There's a luck up. Okay, so watch our stats when I take this luck up pill. See how it went straight to luck and then nothing happened? Yeah. There you go. Knowledge. I'm pretty sure that we're not going to gain more stat ups outside of damage because none of our other stats can go up. We're max on tiers rate, so the game won't register those. We're max on movement speed, so the game won't register those. I would like to get rid of our HP, though. First room, and we've got a red chest, which gave us spiders. Alright! We have found the wrong way second time in a row. Isaac, congrats, we've gotten here. We're taking the viewers with us, all 10,000 plus of them. Unbelievable. To see how far the Isaac series has grown is truly something special. And I get a lot of heartfelt comments every single day talking about everyone remembers how, you know, how little views the Isaac series used to get. And I'm like, man, I know, it's changed my life. As hokey as that sounds, and as cheesy as that sounds, like, Isaac's changed my life. Oh my goodness. Well, I wanted to get rid of all of our HP, and this is definitely how to do it. I kind of wish that we didn't take that Eternal Heart now, but yeah. Experimental Treatment, nah. Experimental Treatment literally doesn't do anything for Libra except hurt it, because it's always going to guarantee lower one stat, so I don't want to do that. And with Goat Head, at least Goat Head will allow us to get rid of our HP here. Assuming that there's an item to take, I mean. I knew that we had something special whenever Husky was like, I'm surprised, like, the Isaac series surprised me. I mean, he didn't have any expectations at all for the Isaac series. I've told this story before. I mean, he was on the end of, like, you know, there's no reason to play it. It's turning people away from the channel. It's like, yeah, I know, because Husky's always right about that sort of thing, which it is true. The Isaac series was actually causing people to turn off the channel. It was causing them to unsubscribe because people didn't want to see Isaac. There's no secret to YouTube. The one inescapable truth of YouTube is that if you post stuff that people want to watch, they're going to watch it. And if you post stuff that people aren't going to want to watch, they're not going to watch it. As herp derpish as that sounds, it remains true. Because there, if you're a variety content producer like I am, which sounds way too fancy for what I actually do. I should probably go back and get the prayer bead. But if you do variety like I do, then you have to be very conscious about what draws stuff to your channel, what draws people to your channel versus what sends people away. And Isaac, for the longest time, was sending people away from the channel. I'm not gonna take up his tail. We gotta go Athame here. Angel Room Chance, really? I thought Rosary Bead made more Soul Heart Strap. I'm thinking of Mom's Pearl. Anyway, head on down the next floor. I mean, what can you say about this run? It's a full boat run. We're gonna destroy Hush here. And then we're gonna go fight the Lamb. We're gonna turn it around, and then we're gonna do it all over again. Because I gotta fight Megastan. BFF's kind of, whatever. Alright, so let's go fight Hush real quick. Get ready for the fastest Hush kill you'll ever see. You might be saying, like, that's impossible, I've seen Hush. How can it be the fastest Hush kill? Your damage isn't that good, Zendikta. You know what you're talking about, Zendikta. That's what I thought. Well, head on down to the next floor. Yes, Chaos Cards do work on Hush. The only boss that Chaos Cards do not instantly kill is Delirium. So we're going to pay a visit to good old Stanley. Say what's going on. Hopefully, where are we? Oh, it's from $3 bill. I was like, why does Maw the Void all of a sudden have Spoonbender? But that makes sense. I forgot that we took $3 bill. Normally, I would never take it, but in a run like this, I mean, there's basically everything and anything is safe to take outside of Isaac's Heart. Okay, and we get Mom's Knife. Good lord, game. I mean, what can you say? What can you really say about this run? Actually, I'm partially convinced that taking Mom's Knife, now that I think about it, was probably not the best move. Because we just ruined a lot of our tier synergy. But oh my goodness, like, I mean, given with how much damage we have, the amount of damage that Mom's Knife is going to do is just absurd. And I will take the Telepills. No, Telepills, thank you. We even found Stanley, like, first try. Look at that, we went straight to him. Balls of Steel, okay.
Balls of Steel.
2-1000, 3-1000, drop. And again, we do that just to weaken, to automatically take Fallen down past phase one, and to get the Bomb Lamprey flies out of the way. So down goes Stanley.
Down goes Stanley.
Not Frasier, but Stanley. Pops Curse. And I will take a look in the mirror here. Yeah, that looks good. Telepills takes us somewhere. Where are we at? I don't know. So we are going to do a victory lap here. Just because, I mean, come on. You gotta explore this. You gotta explore this seed a little bit more. Leave it to the little haunts to spawn inside of you all the time. Somebody was asking where... this is probably a good time to show it off as well. Somebody was asking me, where do you turn on the HUD? like the found HUD and stuff. Go to options. You go to the extra HUD here, and then the found HUD. So these two, these are the two options you want. These are not mods. They're included in the base game. The charge bar is the little red circle that shows up over Isaac's head whenever I'm charging Maw of the Void. And I've been meaning to do that. Like that quick 15 seconds that I just got done showing. Oh my god, we even found the lamb like immediately. What is going on? I'm not even gonna move. You know it's bad whenever you kill yourself on Mom's knife. Back to the front. Here we go. You will do what I say when I say back to the front. You will die when I say you must die back to the front. You coward, you servant, you blind man. I'd offer something like, say, 100 points if you can name that song. But, like, it's going to be answered within the first 10 seconds of people hearing that. If you don't know who it is, Metallica, track 5 off of album number 3. Called Disposable Heroes. Isaac, head on down to the next floor. What's a victory lap? Do you get anything for victory lap? I don't know. I'm not sure if you get anything for the victory lap, to be honest. I've done like 4 or 5 victory laps in a row and gotten nothing for it. I think there's an achievement for doing 100 or something like that, but that's like ridiculous. I mean, maybe like if the leg streak gets to like 300, I'll do a 100 lap victory lap. Or no, you know what? You know what'd be even better than that? It'd probably be even faster. If we hit 100,000 YouTube subscribers, I would do a 100 victory lap Isaac run. If it's possible. I don't know if it's possible or not. So 100,000 YouTube subs, and you will get a 100,000 victory lap Isaac run. And I'll play just as base Isaac with the D6. There you go. That's a good goal. We just crossed 54,000 earlier yesterday. Thank you, everybody. Welcome to all the new subscribers here. I hope you've enjoyed your stay. My name is Invicta. I'm not a very good YouTuber. I mean, I try to stay consistent as much as I can. You know, we didn't have a Lobotomy Corporation episode yesterday, mainly due to the fact that I was just super tired. By the time I got done with all the craziness that was yesterday, I was just out of energy. But today I feel good because today I actually got like some of the best sleep I've gotten in years. And it was because, oh my goodness. Well, I mean, we gotta have. Sorry, Shoop to Whoop. I mean, I love you. I love you and all, but I mean, it's Unicorn Stump. Unicorn Stump, Mom's Knife is Black Judas. This is so, so over. Unicorn Stump will give us invincibility, but it will not give us contact invincibility. Meaning that if we run into things while we're invincible, thanks to Unicorn Stump, we will not actually cause any damage to them. The damage that we cause is going to be brought to the enemies by Mom's Knife. Now I kind of hope that we do get like actual Spoonbender. It'll be kind of nice. Ooh, get another orbital here. All right. There we go. We say no, thank you. Head on down the next floor. All we're looking for is the Angel Room. We want the Angel Room, or we want a self-sacrifice room. That's all we're looking for. That's how we do the rest of the full. Well, that's not all of it, because we still have to do fight Delirium. Don't ask me what's going on with Multidimensional Baby. I have no idea. Multidimensional Baby's freaking the F out right now. But we're just cutting right through everything here. It's not even close. Like this damage is just it's not even like the damage really. It's just the it's just how everything came together that makes this feel like it's a really, really powerful run. We don't need to do the super secret or the boss trap room.
Why are you not using Unicorn Stumps, Invicta? Roar!
I don't know. No reason to. I mean, there's a reason to, but there's, like, not a good reason to. I would argue that it actually takes a little bit longer to clear these rooms than it does if I just simply, you know, kill them. It takes longer to clear it with Unicorn Stump, I mean. And, okay, here we go. Alright, so what we're going to be looking for here is we're looking to fight Uriel and Gabriel to get the key piece. Alright, we got blessed. That means that we've got an angel deal on this floor. Guaranteed, because we have Goat Head. Get the soul. Let's get this bombs. I don't want to lose any HP that isn't, like, isn't self-inflicted. There we go. Hello, Uriel. Goodbye, Uriel. Alright, 7 soul hearts. No! Alright, we're gonna spawn Gabriel. There we go. Alright, so we have the key pieces. We Gucci fam. We all Gucci fam. So now we're guaranteed to fight Mega Satan. Hopefully he gives us a portal to Delirium. And that'll complete the full run. The full run. The full run. I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, oh, HP is getting a little low there, Invicta, Mr. Tough Guy. Look, I'm not a little puppy, all right? And yes, our HP is getting low. Oh no, what will we do? I sure hope that we don't, like, you know, find a whole bunch of HP here, either by way of Maw the Void or, you know, really anything. Yeah, we can fight Uriel again. I ain't scared. Bring it. I just want to get those soul hearts. I'll take Sarah from here. We'll head on down to the next floor, but I mean, just a stellar run. Interesting. Yeah, you weren't expecting that, were you, freaking game? So like I said, not worried about HP. We have enough damage for me to, I can basically protect any amount of HP at any time.
Well, if you're so tough, then how come you just don't stay at 1/2 hearts, Invicta? I thought you were good at this game, Invicta.
Look, we had a Binding of Isaac by the Books episode not that long ago, where I was talking about confidence, not recklessness. You want to be confident, but that doesn't mean you're allowed to be reckless. You can have all the faith in the world that you want for your item build and everything. If your run's going, you know, supercharged and you're destroying fools left and right. But one mistake can cost you a victory. So you can be cocky, you can definitely be confident, but don't sacrifice safety. Don't be reckless. There's no reason to. Because at the end of the day, the only person who loses when you're reckless and you lose and you die is you. You're not, I mean, the game, as much blowharding as I like to do, you know, for the yucks and for the commentary and for YouTube and everything, you know, I'd never put the streak in jeopardy just to, like, oh, I can prove, I'm proving something, you know, like, check this out, girls, you know what I mean? Like, I'm not here trying to impress anyone. You shouldn't do that either. The game is not going to care nor be impressed if you try to do, if you try, like, yeah, I'm just gonna beast mode this, I'm gonna just ignore all the risks and just go face first into a wall. No one's going to admire you for that. The game is not gonna care. So bottom line, you're allowed to be confident. Just don't be reckless. Just because I know that we're gonna win this run over and over and over again does not mean that I'm gonna try try to prove some arbitrary goal of, oh, I can stay at half of a heart all day, every day. This is no problem. I mean, well, now with Dead Cat, maybe, but... yeah. So we get Dead Cat here, and that's going to be fine, because obviously with Goat Head, that means that we can get rid of our Red Heart anyway. I'm just going to blast away. And again, Unicorn Stump gives us invincibility, but does not actually cause any contact damage. It's very good when you have orbitals, especially when you have Mom's Knife. Because it's on a one-room cooldown, so you just simply hit it every time you walk in, and that's about it. Hierophant card, whatever. The Hierophant. And we can essentially just kamikaze everything down here. The only bad thing about Unicorn Stump is that I can't turn Isaac whenever it's active, so you better hope that you're in the position that you want to be in before you hit it. Don't take that out of context, you freaking pervs. I know how the internet thinks. I've been on the internet a couple times. You can't fool me, you lewd people out there. This is where the slime ball YouTuber would be like, unless you're a girl, then call me. Super Secret Room should be to the right of here. Yeah, I mean, the only way that this run gets any better is if we get Guppy. Yeah, sit down, mama. You ain't got nothing. Ain't got nothing. Yeah, we gotta kill Blue Baby and Isaac anyway. And we do get the Sack Altar, which I will take. I didn't mean to take my shadow. I'm gonna take Sack Altar, and we get 4 of freaking Babylon. Man, just all around power. Now I know that Deadeye looks tempting, but it actually wouldn't matter for Mom's Knife. So we're gonna head on down to the next floor. Deadeye does not work with mom's knife. I'm like almost 100% sure on that. Secret room? Yeah, maybe. Nah. Thought maybe we can get lucky and we can bridge the gap. Maybe? Oh, okay. Never lucky. It's alright. Now, what's nice about Maw of the Void is that it will go off if I have it charged whenever I hit the Unicorn Stump. Yeah, the music does kind of get a little bit crazy. I don't think this is where the boss is, but I'm just checking anyway. Okay, yeah, I didn't think so. Oh man, now we're talking. We got Rock Band going on in the background now. So we're gonna go fight. We're gonna go to the chest. We're gonna beat Isaac. We're gonna go to the chest. We're gonna beat Blue Baby. Then we're gonna go fight Megastan. And then, after that, we're gonna go fight Delirium. And if that's not a complete full run, I don't know what is. That's what I have coined the full house run. As you can see, as evidenced by the thumbnail, of course, you all probably know whether or not I've already beaten it because, well, you can see the thumbnail. That wasn't Guppy? I thought... I didn't take Guppy's tail. That's right. I thought that was going to be Guppy for some reason. And yes, I know that we can get a guaranteed Delirium if we go fight Hush again, but I don't really want to fight Hush again. I gotta kill Blue Baby, man. So, you know, that's how this works. I gotta kill everybody. It's not a full house run if I don't beat at least Isaac and Blue Baby. We know that Mom's Heart's gonna be over here. I'm not even worried about the curse room, to be honest. Even though I know that we're only one away from Guppy, it's not gonna matter. And the reason why, in case if you think I'm being too dismissive of that fact, the reason why is because we have Mom's Knife. And Mom's Knife, while it does activate Guppy Flies, it does not activate it on a consistent basis enough for me. It's not like having like a really high tears rate and then you're proccing the mulligan effect of Guppy all the day every day. It's only actively proccing stuff whenever the knife makes contact with the target. So what I'm trying to say is that us not having Guppy is not a big deal. Take some Victor robes here just for more stats up. I think we still have Libra. We'll head on up to the cathedral here. And it's almost a guarantee that Isaac's going to be to the south here. Again, serious note, real quickly. Anyone out there, if you're worried about skipping rooms, there's no shame in skipping a room at all. If you have the ability to skip a room and you just flat out know you don't need to be in there, then why put yourself at risk? Some people feel a little bit self-conscious about skipping rooms and stuff, like it's cheating or like it's, you know, you're playing on easy mode or whatever. It's not. Don't let people make you think or make you feel that. That is some solid damage right there. There's absolutely no shame in skipping a room that you don't have to do. In fact, I would think less of you if you just, for whatever reason, force yourself to fight a room just because you had like some sort of, you had like someone telling you like, oh, you're a pansy if you skip this. Yeah, don't do that. It's not like that. Get purity. Let's go fight Blue Baby. Yes, we don't have to go fight Blue Baby, but I'm looking for the full house run. There's only two bosses left that we haven't killed, and it's Mega Satan and it's Delirium. If we're not including Blue Baby, of course, which I'm about to, because we are about to wax that you know what. I mean, it's not even going to be a fight. It's going to be like we walk in, we laugh at Blue Baby, and then we leave. See, and these are the runs that you have to enjoy. You got to savor the victories. Because we've all had the runs where you basically just can't win. Or at least you can win, but they're not an easy win. But if Isaac was an easy game, then he wouldn't be playing. It wouldn't be all that exciting to watch or to make content for. Because it's like, yeah, the game's too easy. Who wants to win every time without challenge? What in the world was that split right there? Did anyone see the one gurgling split into like 8 different ones? So we walk in, we laugh at Blue Baby, and he's dead. There we go. Did not get a Delirium Portal. The only way that this is going to be sullied is if we do not get a Delirium Portal after Mega Satan, which I'm a little bit scared about now. So hopefully Stanley plays nice and gives us a portal. Is there any reason to teleport? No, because we don't have... Yeah. Yeah, there's no reason to. All right, well, let's go fight Megastan, and let's see if we can get a hold of Delirium afterward. Hopefully we can. Hello, Stanley. How you doing? I'm just being facetious. I don't actually care how you're feeling, Satan. You're the literal devil. I don't need to ask you for help. But thanks for the good music, though. I never really understood the whole like, oh, you know we're doing it, or maybe not. All right, never mind. I was gonna Blackheart bomb Super Envy here and get a Super Pride and get a bunch of Black Soul Hearts, but Seraphim made the job for me. I never understood where the connection between like satanic stuff and heavy metal came from. I mean, again, I wasn't born and raised on heavy metal or music in general. So that surprised me. I was like, wait, does that mean that I'm a Satanist for listening to like Metallica? Which seems preposterous right now, but you gotta remember this is back in like the 1940s, so you know, there's a lot of conservatism going on. Conservatism? Yeah, conservatism, sure. Back before I fought in World War II, I was really concerned about people and how they judged me about listening to this band that wasn't even existing for the next 40 years yet, called Metallica. I was worried that it was associating me with Satanism. You know. But I've seriously never understood where that link comes from. Now, I do know that there are plenty of heavy metal bands that play off of that. You know, like they've got like, you know, they've got like satanic emblems and pentagrams and all this crazy like stage shows and stuff. No, we got denied the full run. The Full House run denied by Megastan. I shouldn't have talked. That's why he did it. I was talking trash about him. Anyway, thank you for watching, everyone. 237 wins in a row. I do appreciate it. Again, Rejoice Seed League Heroes is upon us. Make sure you are giving me those four things. Give me the character you're playing as. Give me the first room item or the first items that I'm supposed to start with. The seed, of course. And make sure it's also an Afterbirth plus seed. And remember, if we hit the 90-day like streak, I'll give away two copies of The Binding of Isaac plus Afterbirth plus exclusively to you all here on YouTube. And I'll be sending that through Steam. So only PC. PC only. If you play it on Switch, if you play it on other consoles, I'm sorry I don't have keys for that. It's only through PC. Only on Steam. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody!